my plan was to be a performer and a performing artist. And so, you know, I really wanted to go to graduate school for choreography and for performance, and probably out of state. I went to UNC here in Greeley for my undergrad. And I flew back from an audition in California, and I was in a really bad car accident the next day. So I was flight for life to the hospital, and just kind of took a different path at that time. Had to retrain how to dance, and at that time, you know, it was kind of dawned on me that my dream of performing on stage wouldn't happen. Yeah, I mean, you kind of go through that time period of resentment, of course, that you're not going to be able to follow that dream and that passion. You know, I felt like I'd been training my whole life to be a dancer and to be a performer, and then eventually moving into the teaching realm. And it happened much, much earlier in retraining. And I actually kind of got to the point where I was like, okay, dance, I was done with it for a little while. You know, dance is not going to be my thing. I think I need to say goodbye to it. And yeah, there is a little bit of sadness that comes with making that change. You know, your identity kind of changes, and so you have to now say, I'm not so much of a dancer and a performer anymore, and now I train others, and I choreograph a ton, and get to teach, and so I feel fortunate that I'm involved in any way, shape, or form in dance. So. Yeah, so students, they definitely bring to the table different aspects, different attributes, and different talent levels. And some of them have more performance quality, where some of them are more technical dancers. And so I think my job is pulling out the creativity side of them and making sure that they feel safe enough to be able to present that material in whatever way they want to. And so really hoping that they that they feel like they can be creative in that moment, in whatever way that is. So if that artistry is coming out and we're pulling it out through choreography, if they want to be kind of behind the scenes doing choreographic work, or if they want to be the technician that's on the stage doing the material, you know, we can kind of share those roles, and they can have an opportunity to do both of those things, which is really fun to watch them kind of grow in both of those ways. I have so many students that I see bits and pieces of myself in them, and you just want to hone that skill, and you want to guide them in the right direction, because again, you want them to find that love, and then also continue that love, that they're not going to get burned out. So if they're so gifted, you know, you put them in those leadership roles. You want them to be the leader in the classroom and outside in the community too. And so it's such a blast to see them grow. I think having them grow, because even if they came in with the most amount of talent ever, they're still, I mean, you can, that's what I love about dance, is it's never ending. And in class, we hope to foster that. You know, that's kind of my job too, is that pushing them a little bit, you know, out of their comfort zone, and then also hoping to find the joy in it for them, that they can get on stage and perform, and that they leave here, whether they're going to be a dancer or not, that they leave here with a sense of self-confidence that they maybe didn't have before. And I'm honest, I share my story of, you know, coming up through the ranks of my ballet company when I was in high school. I was in a pre-professional ballet company. We were weighed in every day, and it was cutthroat competitive. And so after my teacher really wasn't the nicest. And so I thought to myself, I think I can challenge students and make them become better dancers, and I don't have to be that person, and I don't have to have that environment. I love the discipline, especially of ballet. It is, you know, this traditional form, and it's so disciplined, and it's instilling that in each of them. So whether it's for their next class, their next block period, or when they go to an interview at a job, I mean, they're taking all those skills and applying them. And so work ethic is huge. I mean, that's how I learned mine, is that I was showing up to rehearsals on time, ready to go. It helps that when it's your passion, you want to do that and you want to be better at your craft. But I think what they're learning in dance applies across the board. And not only in those ways, but the creative aspect. So thinking outside the box and being willing to try something that maybe somebody else wouldn't, that, you know, they're not pigeonholing themselves. They're really thinking, you know, broadly, maybe when somebody else in another form maybe wouldn't. What's in my plan? I know it's a little bit different now. I teach at UNC, and so we just started a master's program there for dance educators. So I oversee that program. So that was kind of a huge undertaking. So what's beautiful about that is I get to teach freshmen in high school all the way through graduate students. And so there's just this huge spectrum of growth. That's kind of my next step right now, continuing to grow as a teacher, as an educator. As a choreographer too, because that's a big part of my life. And I mean, I love it here at Central. Again, I don't think I could do it without my team. It's amazing. And I like wearing all the hats. It's good. It's good for me. I think it's good. So I don't know what my next plan is. But right now, I have my hands a little bit full. But that's good. Yeah.
Always keep an open mind.
Yes, open mind. I know. And kind of plan, but not plan. And that's what I've learned. That's when doors open.